all are once again welcome to accountancy class grade 12. So the past 3 weeks, 3 sessions, we discussed about a very important one, the perfeiture. So as a perfeiture, you have to learn how you are going to perfeit this as. So once you are going to perfeit, where, which situation you are going to perfeit, a time marker allotment or first call or final call. Thereafter, after perfeiture, how you are going to reissue of shares. So the reissue of shares, so how you are going to calculate it as a perpetual shares. Thereafter, how much money you transfer to capital reserve. For that, we discussed about regarding perpetual. Then other thing, very important thing, as a perpetual, see, as a perpetual of shares under pro rata basis, as you know already, as a pro rata basis, what application of shares is received more than the issued shares. So the differences, how you are going to calculate it. We are going to adjust share allotment or any refusal of the shares. So in this situation, as E is very important, perpetual of shares under pro rata category. Okay, that is the formula here. See, when shares belonging to pro rata category are perpetual. So here, according to shares belonging to pro rata category. So when it was perpetual, amount in arrears on allotment is to be returned. So very important here, what when shares are belonging to pro rata category are perpetual, amount in arrears in allotment is to be determined. How you are going to determine how much money share allotment due not yet paid by the shareholder? In this situation, whenever the perpetual is happened, how you are going to calculate? That's what very important here. So already this calculation we discussed where, when categories based discussion, how, so whenever the given share applied, we are going to calculate how much share allotted, or reverse manner, whenever the given share allotted, we are going to calculate share applied. Same manner here, see, once I can repeat, when shares belonging to pro rata category are perfeited, amount in arrears, this is very important, amount in arrears and allotment is to be determined. So the following process may be followed to determine amount in arrears, very important. So there are two situations. So one is what here, calculate total number of shares applied. So how many shares applied? Why you are going to calculate total shares applied? Because they are given only share allotted. But we want to know how much share exactly applied, then how much share allotted. Then only any excess application money, how you are going to adjust the time of share allotment due, especially for the pro rata basis. Okay, that's what here, calculate total number of shares applied if not given by the shareholders whose shares are being perpetual. So this calculation already discussed where, in category wise, same manner. See, when I'm going to calculate total number of shares applied, suppose it's not given, I was going to calculate, the formula is total shares applied, actually how many shares applied under pro rata category. So this name is very important. We are discussing mostly upon under the pro rata category, how many shares applied divided by total shares allotted. So here applied, here allotted under pro rata category, numerator, denominator. So total shares applied under pro rata category divided by total shares allotted under pro rata category into number of shares actually allotted. So here, when the given number of shares allotted, how we are going to calculate how many shares applied with the help of this formula. So understood? Similarly, here, suppose the given shares, number of shares allotted, if not given. Here, number of shares applied is not given, how we are going to calculate. Here, number of shares allotted not given, how we are going to calculate, reverse manner. They given information about how many shares applied. Actually, how many shares allotted, how we are going to calculate. That's what this formula, see the heading again. Calculate the total number of shares allotted, if not given. What is the formula? Same manner here. So whatever numerator, denominator, it interchange here. Total shares allotted under pro rata category divided by total shares applied under pro rata category into number of shares applied. Okay, number of shares applied. So then we are going to know how many shares allotted by the company as a shareholder, particular shareholder. You understood? That's what the two formula is very, very important. For this formula, whenever we are going to calculate, the missing figure is what? How many shares applied? For that, we are going to calculate this formula. So we are going to count how many shares applied through this. When they given number of shares allotted, year, reverse manner, they not give number of shares allotted, but they given number of shares applied. So based upon this formula, how we are going to calculate number of shares allotted. Okay, now understood for these two formulas, especially the heading stuff for forfeiture of shares and the pro rata category. Now understood. So this formula is not needed for you. Already we discussed when category wise pro rata basis, the same formula discussed. Again, once again, you want to remember the same one. For especially when the time of share forfeited, whenever shares belonging to pro rata category, when shares are forfeited, how we are going to calculate, especially for this amount in arrears and allotment is to be determined. Okay, now I am going to discuss an important problem in NCERT book. For you can discuss collectively all the information. Overall, I am going to discuss now for one problem. Okay, now let's see. Okay, under forfeiture of shares, under pro rata category, we are going to discuss one problem in which take NCERT book, page number 67. We are going to discuss question number 14, numerical question number 14. So before watching this video, please take NCERT book with information, then you can able to follow. Okay. See here, they given what? Roanoke Cotton Limited issued a prospectus inviting applications for 6,000 equity shares of 100 each at a premium of 20 per share. Please underline, inviting applications for how much? Only 6,000 equity shares. Okay. So here you have to write synopsis like this. Okay. Then payable as follows. That's what I written here. Application how much? 20 rupees. Then allotment 50. Including premium. That means what? Premium how much? The book they given. Premium is 20 rupees. Okay. So first call 30 rupees, final call 20 rupees. So how much they invited? Invited only 6,000. Invited 6,000 shares. Okay. Then they given the structure. That's what we discussed. Application 20 rupees, allotment 50. So 50 means inclusion of what? Premium 20 rupees. Then first call 30 rupees, final call 20 rupees. We add all together 100 plus 20. As a nominal value, here 100 nominal value plus 20 premium. So nominal value, this is premium. Okay, so become 120. Then applications were received for 10,000 shares. So received how much? 10,000 as an application. Okay, received how much? 10,000. And allotment was made pro rata to the applicants of 8,000 shares. So allotment pro rata how much? 8,000 shares. This is for the pro rata. Pro rata. Okay. See the next line. The remaining applications being refused. So remaining how much? 2,000. So refused. Actually invited how much? 6,000. Have you understood? They have invited probably 6,000 shares. But how much is received? 10,000 shares. But according to pro rata basis, we consider only 8,000 shares. Balance means what? Here 2,000 shares refused. That means what? Return back the application to the shareholder who were applied. Have you understood the meaning of the information here? Then money received in excess on the application, so I can underline that, was adjusted towards the amount due on allotment. Okay, up to this, no confusion. So here, application received 10,000, pro rata 8,000, 2,000 refused. Now, we start, up to here, we start. Okay, before going to our next page, that is better now. So we read only the half of the problem. For that, we collectively got information. So how to start? As you know, entry, what is first one? As bank account data, see bank account data, how much? Actually, how much applied, application received? This is application received, how much? 10,000, select. So, 10,000, what is application money? 20 rupees. Okay, so 10,000 into 20, how much become? 2 lakh. 2 equity share application money received. 2, so 2 equity share application money account. Okay. So 2 equity share application. Application account. How much? 2 lakh. So what is the narration? Being 10,000 shares received for application money at the rate of 20 per share. Okay, so first narration over. So bank account data 10,000 into 20, 2 lakhs. 2 equity share application account, 2 lakhs. Okay, so entry is over. Now, how much money are going to transfer to share capital? Then how much per share allotment, then how much per going to refuse. That's what this line. Read once again. They given what? Applications were received for 10,000 shares. And allotment was made pro rata for 8,000 shares. The remaining application being what? Refused. So money received in excess on application was adjusted towards the amount given allotment. Now see the second entry, very important one. This is the second entry. What is that? We're going to transfer. Equity, this equity. Okay. So one first entry over. So equity share application upon 2 lakhs. Okay, how much shares are going to transfer to equity share capital account? That is very important. So, 2 equity share capital account. You become confused. Whether I take 10,000 or 8,000 or 6,000. So, actually how much you are invited to the public? How many shares you are going to invite to the public? Only the 6,000 shares. Okay. So this is the pro rata basis. Okay. The remaining shares, whatever the excess at the pro rata basis in the application money, we are going to adjust on what? Share allotment. Now see, how many shares are going to take? Only 6,000 shares. Okay. So 6,000 into 20. So 1,20,000. Understood? This is very important. 6,000 shares into 20. 6,000 into 20, 1,20,000. Thereafter, going to adjust what? Equity share allotment. Okay. So now, make it blank. We don't know how much you're going to adjust. Before that, these are going to reduce, isn't it? The 2 bank account. How much are going to refuse, return back to the money again? 2,000 shares into 20. So how much? 2,020, 40,000. Naturally, what's the difference from the 2 lakhs? So balance, equity share allotment upon this what? 40,000. So understood. That's what is my 2 lakhs? Equity share application account. But transfer, equity share capital, how much? 6,000 shares, rate of 20 to 1,20,000. Then, any excess application money, I'm going to adjust equity share allotment upon 40,000. Then, two bank account. So, 2000 sats, I am going to reduce. So, 2020, 40,000. I have understood for 2 lakhs. In narration, you know, being share application. Money transferred and excess adjusted towards share allotment and balance of 2000 shares. Refused to allow. I think what? They return back the money, this amount. So, this 40,000, I'm going to adjust for the share allotment and for future due. Now, understood the second entry, that's what the discussion up to this. Now, let's see, tan SP, what is that? See, next one. SP, query number 68. What are they given? Rogi. To whom 300 shares were allotted, failed to pay allotment and calls money. Okay. So here, Rogit, even they failed to pay allotment and calls money. So Rogit to whom 300 shares were allotted, failed to pay allotment and calls money. So each shares were forfeited. So when they forfeited, even after the allotment, even call money also, they due shares forfeited. So, the 300 shares, for what happened? They forfeited for at the time allotment itself. Okay, here we will make it, at the time of allotment, they are going to pass what entry. Now you know, what is the share allotment due entry? Okay, so what is the exact due entry for that? See, third one, you want to know, share allotment. Equity share allotment account return. How much? 6,000 only. We'll consider always for what? 6,000. Okay, 6,000 into what is my allotment? The entire 50. Okay, so 6,000 into 50, 3 lakhs. Okay, then 2 equity share capital account. So how much we are going to mention here? Again, 6,000 into 30. So 1,80,000 to securities premium reserve. How much again? 6,000 into 20. So 1,20,000. Now understood. Here breakup given. Actually, how much you are going to transfer to equity share capital account? How much you are going to transfer to security premium reserve account? Okay. So that's what 3 lakhs spread over 1,80,000 and 1,20,000. Narration, you know, being share allotment due. Okay. Now, what is our fourth entry? Okay. What is our fourth entry? What is the fourth entry? I will clear this. So, my continuation, my fourth entry, we want to know how much money actually received. Okay. Here, equity share I suppose to say how much? 3 lakhs. Okay. So equity share allotment. Equity share allotment account. I'm going to calculate. How are you going to calculate? How we are going to calculate for that? See here, discussion is what? Rohit to whom 300 shares were allotted, failed to pay allotment and calls money. His shares were forfeited. Okay, so they failed to pay at the time of allotment itself. Okay, now we are going to calculate how much allotment should receive. Okay, so how to calculate for that? Now see the 14 notes. You have to write calculation of amount. So I have just taken it this one. So what is the thing you have to write? Calculation of amount. So it is working out. One. Calculation of amount due. Calculation of amount due, but not paid on allotment. But not paid on allotment by Rohit. How to calculate? This is the dip we are going to discuss. So as you know, Rohit, they allotted only 300 shares. We are going to calculate how much Rohit applied. Okay. So now we are going to do number of shares applied by Rohit. That we are going to calculate. So what is the formula? You know, as a missing figure is number of shares applied. So how we are going to calculate? So total number of shares applied by pro rata basis divided by total shares by allotment by pro rata basis into number of shares allotted. That is the formula. Okay. So now how we are going to calculate? What is total shares applied? Can you write the total shares applied how much? Total shares here applied how much? Very important. As you know, 8,000 is applied. Actually allotted how much? 6,000 only. Now understood. That's what. Now applied is 8,000, 6,000 is only allotted. Balance to, even though 10,000, they apply 2,000, we return back. Okay, now we are going to consider only, this is the ratio. So, what is the formula here? How many total number of shares applied? I am going to write here 8,000, the pro rata basis, divided by number of shares allotted, the pro rata basis 6,000, into number of shares allotted. How many shares? Number of shares allotted 300. Correct? That's why 300 are allotted to Rohit, isn't it? They are going to allotted Rohit 300. Now how to calculate? See here, I cancel all 30 here. The 30 here. Maybe 3 2s are 6, 4 2s are 8. Okay. Then I cancel this 3. So how many shares applied? They applied. Number of shares applied how many? 400 shares they applied. This is the first information. Number of shares applied by Rohit. How many shares with the help of this formula? So understood now? Again, the missing figure here is number of shares actually how much applied. So we are going to calculate this. Now you will be understood now. So they are given only number of shares allotted. But you want to know exactly how many shares applied by Rohit. That's what the formula here. Total number of shares applied as a pro rata category divided by number of shares allotted as a pro rata category into number of shares allotted to the Rohit. So you get it. How many shares? 400 shares. With the cancellation of the information. Now we are going to discuss. Okay. So very important one. The application money received from Rohit. Application money received. Application money received from Rohit. So how much? So we have to write. Yeah, write it. Received from Rohit. Okay, application we received from Rogi.
How much?
That's what we're going to calculate. So now 400, that's now you got it, into 20. Okay, so you will get it, how much? 8,000. Actually, how much money application? Through allotment, now see here, now less. Okay, how less what? Application money due. Application money due from allotment. How much? Only this 300, isn't it? So 300 only allotted. So 6,000. Okay, so balance 2,000. This is what our first, what is that? Excess application money adjusted on allotment. You have to write. Excess application money, excess application money adjusted on allotment. Okay, first you got it. Now the Rogit, even though he applied 400 shares, he allotted only 300 shares. So naturally, how much money excess application he got? Only 2,000. Okay, now the exact total share allotment due, how much? 3 lakhs. So how much are going to receive? Now let's see how the calculation. Okay, now you got it. This information. Okay, just watch it. Once again, some minute I'll give time for the calculation. Let's see. Okay. Now, I'm going to discuss next one. What is that? I'll clean it here. It's a continuation. Again, I'll clean it here. Okay. Now, we're going to see how much allotment money do you want? Actually, how much allotment money due on allotment money due on share allotment. Okay, so how much you know for Rogit, only a discussion. 300 into this 50. Okay, so how much? 15,000. Okay, now he has to pay allotment money. Do you want the allotment by Rohit? Okay, so how much money is going to adjust? Already you paid how much? This 2,000 remaining rupees for application, excess application money. Now we're going to adjust share allotment due by the Rohit. So how to write? So excess application money, so less. Excess application money, application money, excess application money adjusted on allotment. How much is this? 2,000. So this is the money, 13,000. So this 2,000, I'm going to write it here. Understood. So now, what is the exact due for him? This is the allotment money due. So this is the allotment, allotment money due, but not received from, but not received from Rohit. Okay, this is the money. So this is 13,000. This is supposed to pay how much? 15,000. But already this 2,000 excess application money adjusted. So he is supposed to pay how much? 13,000. But what happened? He is default for payment of share allotment. That's what here. Allotment money due, but not PCV reform, we have given how much? 13,000. So, first part over, second part, now third part, still they are working at number one, continuation. That's what very interesting. Now, let's see, continuation. Okay, the continuation what? Actually, exact share allotment due how much? That's very important. So, total share allotment on your due how much? Just 3 lakhs, isn't it? So, 3 lakhs. But already this 40,000, this we received excess. That we are going to adjust now. So less the excess share application money. So less excess application money. Excess share application money adjusted now for allotment. How much? This 40,000. Okay, see here. Make this 40,000. That's what already we adjusted. So, we suppose this is how much? 2,60,000. But, again, Rohit is a default. He not yet paid for share allotment money. So, again, less. Again less share allotment money due. Share allotment money due. But not received. Received from Rohit. How much? 13,000, this one. Correct? So 13,000. Now exact how much you are going to receive? Only 2,47,000. 2,47,000. Okay, this 13,000 are going to deduct. So this money is still due for us. We are supposed to receive 3 lakhs. Okay, but already we received some excess application money and now we are going to adjust it on share allotment. I am going to receive 1,60,000. But unfortunately what will happen? Rohit allotment money not yet paid how much? 30,000. I suppose this is how much? 2,47,000. This is the share allotment money received. Share allotment money received. Okay. So how much now we are going to mention here? That's why this is working out number one, detailed one. Continuing out number 1, the entire thing of this general entry, we are going to calculate it. First we calculated actually how many shares applied by the Rohit, 400 shares. Through that we calculated how much the exact due for the share allotment due from the Rohit. Then exact how much money received through one allotment. So 2,47,000. 2,47,000. 2 equity share allotment account, 2,47,000. Understood? That's what continuation of our fourth entry. For the fourth entry, this is a working note continuation. Or this working note continuation. Okay, now let's see. Now the next entry we're going to discuss now. Okay, let's see how the calculation here. Once again. Please watch carefully. Continuation. Okay. Now let's see the continuation, page number 68. See, Rohit to whom 300 shares allotted failed to pay allotment. That's what we got it because of the failure of the Rohit. Finally, how much exact money share allotment received after adjustment of share application and Rohit default. Bank account data, equity share allotment account working note, 247,000. Then see, Rohit to whom 300 shares were allotted, failed to pay allotment, but underline. And callsman, his shares were forfeited. So even if default of calls also. Then next line, now we are going to discuss shares. How much shares exactly due and received. See, Ithika who applied for 600 shares, underline. Ithika who applied for 600 shares, failed to pay the two calls. And her shares were also forfeited. Here, which is very, very important. Given Ithika who applied for 600 shares. So what is the missing figure? Here, we are going to calculate how many shares allotted to Ithika. Then only we are going to discuss the default of two calls, first and second call. Now understood here. Earlier discussion, the given allotment for the Rohit, we found exact how much application applied by the Rohit. Here, Ithika, they applied for how many? 600 shares. But exactly how much allotted to Ithika? That's what the first calculation we are going to discuss. Thereafter, we will see. So as you know, what is the entry for this situation, a continuation of this. Okay. See here, fifth one. What is the fifth one? Equity, share equity. So next entry is what? Equity, share, first call, account. Better. How much? Same? 6,000. So this is what? Now action allotted. This is applied. Okay. So 6,000. Equity share first call account how much? 6,000 into what is our first call? This one. 30 rupees. Okay. So suppose to receive how much? 1,80,000. 6,000 into 30. See 1,80,000 to equity share capital account. How much? 1,80,000 narration billing equity share first call P. Now, what is this one? You know very well. This one is what? How much you have to receive through share first call? So bank account data. See, bank account data to equity, this one, equity share first call account. So yeah, we can't write directly 1,80,000. That's what. Rohit also failed to pay two calls. And Ithika also failed to pay two calls. Yeah, Ithika, they given how many shares applied. Now we are going to calculate how many shares allotted. That's what working note number 2 for this. 2. Okay, now Ithika. We are going to discuss. See, so for Ithika, applied shares how much? Applied shares is 600. Given the applied, how much allotted? Because of this prorata. Okay. As a prorata. So Ithika applied shares is 600. Okay. So now we are going to calculate shares allotted to Ithika. How? Again the formula. Here, what is the formula? Total allotment share. So, total allotment share allotted through priority category divided by total allotted how much? 6,000. Total applied share through priority category how much? 8,000. So, ulta. So, earlier we done 8,000 divided by 6,000 for getting how much applied calculation we have got. Through that formula. Here, through this formula, we are going to get how much allotted. See, this is what exact total number of shares allotted two Prorata category divided by total shares applied to Prorata category into number of shares applied by Pithiga. How much? 600. Now understood. So now we will know exact how much shares allotted. See here, cancel, cancel. Okay. Then 4 2s are 8, 3 2s are 6. Okay. Then 1 4s are 4, 20. Okay. So 3 into 150. Actually, how much allotted? Allotted shares. 450 shares. Okay. Applied is what? 600. So allotted shares. This shares allotted to Ithiga. 450 shares. Okay. Now we are going to calculate. What is the amount exactly received? Okay. As you know, share first call. Equity share. First call due. How much? As you know, 180,000. But what happened? Less equity share. First call. Not paid by Rohit and Ithiga. Now how much? 300 by Rohit plus Ithiga, this one, 450, not 600. Okay, that's why we are going to calculate this. Total how many shares? 750 into 30. This is default. Equity share first call, not paid by Rohit and Ithiga. How much? Total 750 shares into 30. How much are going to get? We are going to get 750 into 30, you are going to multiply. Okay, let's see the multiplication. So 0, 0, 5, 3, 7, 5, 1, 22,500. So how much you received? 180,000 divided by 22,500. Going to receive 157,500. 157,500. Okay, so this is what? Amount received by share first call. So understood. So 157,500 we are going to write it here. 157,500. 157,500. What is the entry here? Bank account data 157,500 to equity share first call account 157,500 being how many shares actually? 5,250 shares. How? You know, as a 6,000 minus 750 shares not received. So 5,250, you will get this amount. Correct. So being 5,250 shares, 250 shares, 5,250 shares, at the rate of 30 per share received for equity share first call. You understood? So that's what our bank account data 157,500 to equity share first call account 157,500. Now go for the continuation. Again, 7th one. Okay, here itself I made it. Now, this is the journal entry. Now, going for the 7th one. 7 and 8. What is that? Equity share, final call. So, not first. Again, I am changing here. Equity share, final call. Okay. So what is the final call? again equity share, final call account. Suppose this is how much? 6,000 into this 20 rupees. Okay. So 6,000 into 20, suppose this is how much? 120,000. To equity share, capital account, 120,000. Okay. Again, bank account data, now we are going to calculate opening out number 3. To equity share, final call account. Account how much? Simple. Here 20 rupees, same manner. Here I am going to write it. Equity share, final call due. Equity share, final call due. Not 1,80,000. Okay, so 1,20,000. As 1,20,000, equity share, final call, not paid by Mithun and Nithiga. Equity share, final call, not paid by Rohit and Nithiga, how much? 750 into 20. Okay, 750 into 20. Okay, how much is not paid? Sound 15 to 20, so 0, 0, 5, 2, 10, 0, 1, so totally 15, isn't it? So how much amount received by share, final call? Amount received by share, final call. So 1,05,000 only we received in the form of share, equity share, final call. That's what I am going to write it here. Bank account return, equity share, final call. The bank account return, how much? Working out number 3. This is working out number 3 here. After this calculation, this is working out number 3. How much? So 1,05,000. So 1,05,000. Bank account return to equity share, final call account. 1,05,000. The ratio being 5,000 to 50 number of shares at the rate of 20 per share received for equity share final call. Equity share final call. Understood. Last two entry, very easy one. Share. So that's what you are up to 8 entries you completed. So normal entries. So whatever share issued, even the share issued 6,000, we received 10,000. So only 8,000 through the data basis you are accounted. Balance 2,000 refused. So you return back to the money. That's what your second entry. Third entry, share all fund due. Fourth entry, actually how much share issued because of default of Rohit. Even Rohit not even paid by share allotment. Thereafter, share first call, how much due, how much received. So second call, how much due, how much received. Now we're going to discuss, it's very very important. For what? See the line, the last one. See. Rohit to whom 300 shares were allotted, failed to pay allotment, uncalled money. His shares are forfeited. How many shares? 300. Again, Ithiga applied for 600 shares. So now we know 450 shares only allotted. We consider now only 450 shares. Failed to pay 2 calls and our shares were also forfeited. Okay. So all these shares were sold to Karthik as fully paid for 80 per share as a reissue. How much? Then give general entries the books of the company. Okay. Now let's see how we are going to pass general entries for reissue. Okay. See, now we are going to discuss for future entries. It's a very, very important session. Please listen carefully. Here, we can't do for future entry for entire 750 shares. Why, sir? You can ask the question. Now, see. See, the Rohit, how many shares going to forfeit? 300 shares. Okay. So, here, this is the 9th entry. Features shares of Rohit. How many shares? 300 shares. Why? Because even the share allotment itself, Rohit, not yet paid share allotment also. So naturally coming under which category? That is very important. It is coming under premium has not been received, isn't it? Okay, that's what very, very important. That's what you are going to pass. Rohit, we are going to pass separate perpetual entry. Thereafter, Ritika, going to pass separate perpetual entry. Now, Pastor C is going to pass perpetual entry for Rohit. Because share allotment itself is default, not paid. So, company call 20 rupees. Okay, and allotment here 30 rupees. 30 plus 20, correct. So, here itself, Rohit is default. So, how to pass general entry? So, as you know now, we are going to debit what? Equity share capital account. See, equity share capital account. How many shares? 300 shares into, very important, we are going to debit how many shares? Up to called up. So 20 rupees they called, 30 rupees they called. So here we want to show separate security premium reserve, that's right. 20 plus 30, how much? 50. So, that 300 into 50, how much? Now, understood? How we are going to write the entry? Now, clear, very clearly. So, total how much you call? One conclusion. So, they call the entire thing, the default, share allotment, share first call, share final call. So, entirely they called up. But unfortunately, even share allotment, premium has not been received. Okay. So, 300 into 100. How much? 30,000. Then go to show separately because of this. Securities premium reserve account. That are. Again, how much? 300 into 20. Now we know 36,000 debit. Now let's see the Rohit default. First one what? 2 equity share allotment account. You know how much? That's what you've done when you go through the working out number 1. Actually, how much money not paid by Rohit in the form of share allotment? 13,000. Correct. So that's what we're going to write, 13,000. Is it not yet paid? Isn't it? 2 equity share first call account. That's in a very well how much? 300 into 30. So 9,000. Okay. So 9,000 you are unable to pay. Correct. Then 2 equity share final call. Then how much? 300 into 20. Okay, so default. 300 into 20, how much? 6,000. These are the default. So that 13,000 share allotment money not paid by Rohit and 9,000 not paid by through the form of share first call by Rohit, 300 shares. Again, leave the share final call, 300 shares. Not paid by Rohit, 6,000. So company took the share perpetual amount. How much? 2 perpetual shares account. How much? So actually he has to pay. He paid only how much? 20 rupees. How many shares? 400 shares. That's our true working note number 1. Allotted 300. But how many applied? We calculated through working note number 1. Correct. 400. He ultimately paid only application, this one. Correct. Application money only. That's what. Company going to perfect the amount. How much? 8,000. Okay. Now you make it, mention it. So our debit total 36,000. When you add all here, you get 36,000. 13,000 plus 9,000, how much? As here, 22. Okay. Then 6,000, 28 plus 8,000. 36,000. You check it, the debit and credit should be 10. So that's what, even though you are missing figure, you have to compare with exact calculation. That's what everywhere I calculated. This equity share allotment account, here we can't mention length, isn't it? 350, you get 15,000, correct. That's what the exact amount, how much? They default 13,000. Here, first call default, second call default. Here, how much money took by the company? 8,000. You understood now? This is coming under, premium has not been received. That's why I shown separately premium account. Now, going for Ithiga. Ithiga is what? Ithiga, the application Ithiga paid. Allotment also Ithiga paid. So naturally, yes, coming under, premium has been received. But this one, premium has been received. Okay, so how many shares going to forfeit for Ithiga? Not 600 shares. We are going to consider only the 450 shares. That's why bracket I have written. You understood? Not 600. That is applied. We consider only for 450 shares. So what is this self-perpetual entry for Ithiga? This is also self-perpetual. Sir, I am not writing a narration. Being 300 shares of Rohit perpetual. Okay, that is very important. Now, list for feature entry for Ithiga, again, equity, share, capital, account. How much? As you know very well. How much? It is 450 into 100. Understood how? See, application count up, allotment count up, first count count up, final count count up. Okay, they default only this two only. Understood? Ithiga. So this is the 450 calculation, not given in the problem. You only calculated through working note. Okay. So now, equity share capital account, 450 into 100. Two, it's default of what? Two, equity share. First call. You know how much? 450 into 30. How much? 450 into 30, 13,500. Sorry, here I have to mention the good side, 45,000. Single. Side equity share capital account, 450, 100, up to called up value, 45,000. Premium, we have not mentioned here, removed. That's why heading is what? And the premium has been received, how the general entry will be. That's what two classification here, especially for the perpetual entry. Here, premium has not been received, how the perpetual share will be. Here, premium received, how the general entry. Equity share capital account, 450,100. To equity share first call, due how much? 13,500. Then, to equity share final call, you know, 450 into 20, isn't it? So, 450 into 20 how much? Become 9,000. Okay. Now how much share forfeited? Two forfeited shares. You know very well. They are given 20 rupees and they are given 30 rupees. Premium excluded. Okay. So, 450 into 50. So how much you get it? That is very important. So 22,500. 22,500. You total this, you get 45,000. You understood? Equity share capital account for 450 shares in rate of 100, 45,000. To equity share first call 450 into 30, 13,500. To equity share final call 450 into 20, 9,000. Finally, how much money taken by the company because of default of share first call and final call to perpetual shares, account how much? 450. The Ithiga paid 20 rupees application and 30 rupees for share allotment. Here, premium is excluded. Here also excluded. That's why here also excluded. Be careful here. Here included premium. Here not included because the default only first call and second call. That's what here we consider up to the called up and how many money, how much money taken by the company? 450 into 50, 22,500. How you make it total? Make 45,000. That's what you have. Two type of arbitrary entry here. Premium has been not been received how the general entry. Here, premium received how the general entry. Now, reissue. Continuation 9, 10, and 11th one. This is for reissue entry. Okay, reissue. What is the entry? As we know, bank account data. Bank account data. So how much you got to reissue? The rate of 80 rupees. See your book, Karthik. Okay, so 750 shares. How 750? 300 plus 450. 300 for Rogi, 450 for Vidiga. So become 750 shares. They are going to reissue. Your entire shares going to reissue. 750 into the rate of 80. So how much you get? 750 into 850, you get how much? Exactly 60,000. Isn't it? So 0058 40 04. So 8 sevens are 56 plus 4 60,000. So 750 into 80. So this, if you do like this, the work is very easy. Now perpetual shares. What is that? Discounted, correct? Perpetual shares account data. How much? Again 750 into 20, because you are issued less than the nominal face value. So how much you are losing? 20 rupees. That's it. I am going to debit which one? Perpetual shares account. 750 to 20. How much exactly is coming under? 15,000. Isn't it? So 0, 0, 5 2s are 10. 0. Okay. Then 7 2s are 14 plus 1, 15. So 15. So what is our equity share capital to? Equity share capital account. How much? As you know very well, 75,000. Narration being 750 shares reissued to who? Kartik at the rate of 80 per share. That's what you are. 11th end. Now the climax. 12th end. What is that? How much money you are going to transfer? It's a very interesting part now. So, perpetual shares account data to capital reserve account. So, any excess money in perpetual shares account transfer to where? Capital reserve account. Now we are going to know how much. See carefully. Here, how much money perpetual? 8,000. Okay, perpetual shares account. Here, how much money perpetual? 22,500. Okay, so now total how much? 30,500. 30,500. So, what is our debit? Company losing. Discounted for three shares are 15,000. So minus 15,000. Now how much will you get? 15,500. Perpetual shares account data 15,500 to capital reserve 15,500. Narration being perpetual shares account transfer to capital reserve account. Okay, that's why it's very very important. This 8,000, this 22,500 together, the total money taken by the company. How much company losing? 15,000. So difference is what? Excess share perpetual money transferred to where? Capital reserve account 15,500. So our answer is what? You check it in your book. Finally, you get it. How much money you transfer to capital reserve. Okay. So that's what our total how many entries are going to discuss. Totally 12 entries. So in this problem, we discussed through pro rata basis. Then how you are going to forfeit when premium has been received, not received. Thereafter reissue entry. Thereafter capital reserve entry. Here beauty is what? The entire share forfeited. suppose part of the partly shares perfected, the separate calculation is there. Here, whatever shares perfected, the entire 750 reissued, and whatever difference money directly transferred to where? Capital reserve account. Now, understood, I hope that this is a lengthy sum. We have to discuss the entire discussion for our last 1 month, maybe 1.5 months. Okay, for preparation of this 12 entries. Before that, you want to know how to post general entries. So, wherever you want to mention the calculation, that's what. Simply by one time, it is very difficult to follow. So, my request, please watch several times for this video. Then only, it's very easy for you to know, discuss for further sums in our NCERT book. That's why this is the important discussion. Taken the problem from NCERT book. So, how the entry will be, how the working notes will be going to calculate, how the process, so how the general entry for the separation of perpetual. You can't make it single perpetual entry. You can make it two perpetual entry. Then very, very important here, and go perpetual only after only the final call. See your book. They given only what? End of the calls only, the company going to perpetual. Okay, that is very, very important. Otherwise, what will happen? Sometimes they're going to perpetual the time of share allotment itself. Okay. So now I hope that you understood for this session. It's a very lengthy one. It's a very important session. Please watch several times. Then only you can be able to understand for the detailed problem. Okay. I hope that. Thank you very much.